So if you need to go grab headphones now, please do. Announcement-wise, you may notice in the bulletin that I will be out of town. And that is a vacation. I'm headed out to Nebraska. And so if you have any pastoral emergencies, Pastor Chuck is on call. Are there any other announcements that need to come before the congregation?
Would you mind just practicing choir after church?
Choir practice after church?
It's in the bulletin, the next Sunday, 2 o'clock, the worship music committee's working on Christmas for the Christmas tree, and everybody's welcome to participate.
That's right, we've got some work to do here at the church, 2 o'clock next Sunday. Thank you, Charlie. Any other announcements? Is there anybody we need to add to our prayer list? I have Carmen Hoffman, who's going to surgery. Who else? All right. Well, if there's nothing else, then let's prepare our hearts and minds for worship with our prayer on our new organ. Oh, are you like holding your breath to hear it for the first time? I'm really excited. But we're trying not to make Amanda more nervous. It's a chance to be
cool. And there may be more adjustments to come. So bear with us as we get adjusted.
Merciful God, we confess that we are happy to sin and cannot free ourselves.
mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thank you. Almighty and ever-living God, who anointed your beloved Son to be priest and sovereign forever, grant that all the people of the earth, now divided by the power of sin, may be united by the glorious and gentle rule of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Reading from Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set in place, and an ancient one took his throne. His clothing was white as snow, and the hair of his head like pure wool. His throne was fiery flames, and its wheels were burning fire. A stream of fire issued and flowed out from his presence. 1,000,000 served him, and 10,000 times 10,000 stood attending him. The court sat in judgment, and the books were opened. As I watched in the night visions, I saw one like a human being coming with the clouds of heaven. And he came to the Ancient One and was presented before him. To him was given dominion and glory and kingship, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not pass away. And his kingship is one that shall never be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read responsibly from Psalm 93. The Lord is King, robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. The Lord has made the world so sure that it cannot be moved.
And ever since the world began, your throne has been established. You are from everlasting.
The waters have lifted up, O Lord. The waters have lifted up their voice. The waters have lifted up their pounding waves.
Mightier than the sound of the many waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea, mightier is the Lord who dwells on high.
Your testimonies are very sure, and holiness befits your house, O Lord, forever and forevermore. A reading from Revelation. Grace to you and peace from him who is, and who was, and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and freed us from our sins by his blood, and made us to be a kingdom, priests serving his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds. Every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And on his account, all the tribes of the earth will wail. So it is to be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty, the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
Yeah. Jesus' voice with our ears, right? We hear Jesus through other people. So, do you know anybody that goes to church and loves Jesus? Yeah? Those would be good people to talk to, and you might be able to hear about Jesus and hear Jesus through them. Who else might you be able to hear about Jesus through them, or hear Jesus through them? A pastor, sure. I was hoping someone would say that. A Sunday school teacher, a parent, other people who love Jesus, and the Bible. Sure, those are all great ways to hear Jesus. So, I guess the goal is to try and focus in, like you've got noise-canceling headphones on, right? Try to focus in on hearing what Jesus has to tell you and where Jesus wants to lead you. So let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving us people who can lead us and show and help us to hear your voice. Do not get involved. David
he and his followers of this world, then naturally they would use the primary tool of this world, the primary tool that this world provides for establishing human power, and that is violence. But Jesus is not of this world, and so Jesus will not defend himself through violence. Jesus will not establish his claims by violence. Jesus will not usher in God's kingdom by violence. Jesus will make no followers by violence. Rather, Jesus has come to witness to the truth that God is love, and that because we have not seen God and have such a hard time imagining God, all too often our imaginations are dominated by our experience. So rather than imagining that God is love, we imagine God to be violent because we live in a world of violence. Rather than recognize the cross as a symbol of sacrificial love, we assume it's the legal mechanism of punishing Jesus in our stead, because we have way too much experience with punitive relationships. Rather than believe that God's grace and acceptance are absolutely unconditional, we assume God offers love, power, and status only on the condition that we fear, obey, and praise God, and despise those who don't, because so much of our life is quid pro quo. But Jesus is not of this world, and therefore his followers will not fight for him, because to bring the kingdom about by violence is to violate the very principles of this kingdom and cause its destruction. Could there be a more timely passage to reflect on after the atrocities we continue to witness in this world? We live in a world dominated by the view that the only answer to violence is more violence. And the end result of that view is death. Does that mean Jesus is calling us to be pacifists? Some traditions, particularly Mennonite, Quaker, and the Church of the Brethren believers, have given vivid testimony to the power of Christian nonviolence. These courageous and countercultural witnesses have at times shaken the powers that be and cannot and should not be quickly discarded. Our own tradition, influenced by Martin Luther's sense of God's two hands, also called two kingdoms, has stressed that temporal authorities, like armies and law enforcement, have a critical role to play in creating a more orderly and more just world, which is why it is particularly painful when law enforcement falls short of its calling. Standing in this tradition, I think the perpetrators of the violence and terrorists everywhere should be opposed vigorously, fought tirelessly, and brought to justice whenever possible, so that there is less such violence in the world. On the other hand, as members of the church and followers of a very different kind of king, we also need to witness that there are limits to the reach and outcome of force. As Martin Luther King Jr., another champion for Christian nonviolence, wrote, "The ultimate weakness of violence is that it is a descending spiral, begetting the very thing it seeks to destroy. Instead of diminishing evil, it multiplies it. Through violence, you may murder the liar, but you cannot murder the lie, nor establish the truth. Through violence, you may murder the hater, but you do not murder hate. In fact, violence merely increases hate." And so it goes. Returning violence for violence multiplies violence, adding deeper darkness to a night already devoid of stars. Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. So what does all this mean for us this Sunday? Well, we gather this Sunday to pray and to witness, to pray that God may comfort those who mourn, strengthen those who seek to thwart terrorists, and bring them to justice. Change the hearts of those who can see no other way forward but through violence, and equip all of us to work for a peace born of equity, for only such a peace will last. And after our praying, we are called to witness. To witness to the one who demonstrated power through weakness, who manifested strength through vulnerability, who established justice through mercy, who built the kingdom of God by embracing a confused, chaotic, and violent world, taking its pain into his own body, dying the death it sought, and rising again to remind us that light is stronger than darkness, love is stronger than hate, and that with God, all things are possible. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Almighty God, you love us and free us through the death and resurrection of your Son. Lead your church through the gospel. Bless pastors, deacons, musicians, teachers, and all who speak your truth. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You reveal your goodness through the majesty of what you have created. Bring favorable weather to places affected by storm. Protect plants and animals from devastation. And guide us in our use of all natural resources. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You desire justice in the world. Grant to courts wise and discerning judges, attorneys, and public defenders. Guide the rulers of nations to bring about peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You are our beginning and end. Soothe the afflicted. Comfort the distressed. Console the bereaved. And heal the sick. We pray especially for those we've named on our prayer list. For Carmen Hoffman. And those whom we now name silently or aloud. Give all who provide care a measure of your compassion and peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
You call us to serve our neighbors. Nourish us with word and sacrament so that we may serve as your hands and feet in the world. Protect those who are traveling and bless those who are unable to attend worship today. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Your dominion is forever and ever. We give thanks for the faithful departed who live with the saints of all ages in your infinite love. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Hear our prayers, spoken and sent, that we commend to you this day, trusting in your abundant mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Thank you.
O God of justice and love, we give thanks to you that you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need, awaken us to the needs of others, and at the end, bring all the world to your feast. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Amen.
Let us go now in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thank you.